Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some... with another episode of that there Let's Play an Indeterminate Amount of Sunless Sea. The series that name is a complete and utter fucking lie, because far from being an indeterminate amount, the amount of episodes is predetermined, and that amount is 10. Yes, so we're just here with some more Sunless Sea. We are gallivanting off gaily around the place. I believe there's probably... I think there's something directly beneath us. Directly beneath us just then. That is something that we use in Submariner. But of course I'm not doing Submariner just yet. Bonnie Reefs. Now the thing is there actually a... No, wait, there is a port here, if I recall correctly. We're near Port Cecil. I think we are, no? Is Port Cecil near the Bonnie Reefs? Oh dear, we have a pirate. Okay, I think I may be completely wrong. I think Port Cecil may be a bit further away. Yes, yeah, I believe it's a bit further away. Oh God, please don't. Why? I have nothing for you. I carry nothing of value. At Port Cecil. Ah, dear, I knew Port Cecil was nearby. Port Cecil from Night's Vale. It's not at all. Sorry, got a message from a friend of mine. Okay. Source the Silver Glow, a haven for players of games. Rumpled convolutions of coral fill the water, glimmering with silvery light. The harder you look, the more you see shapes amid the chaos, almost as if they were sculpted. This one could be a crenellated castle that run a horse's head. Yes. A neat little port huddles into the side of a coral island, the prosaic imperial docks and houses tucked away in a baroque organic chaos. In that curious silvery light among the frozen chaos of coral, the scene has the unreal air of a pencil sketch, crumpled and discarded. Right, well, fucking Blemigans. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, if any of you are watching this and you know how the fuck you get a Blemigan, tell me, because I really want, because there's so many things that say, do you want to put a Blemigan ashore? And I've never found a fucking Blemigan. Like, I don't know where you get the sons of fuckers. Okay. Let's get the port apart while we're here. The older inhabitants of Port Cecil carry coral incrustations like a disease, splotched with silvery light. They like to go up into the limestone heights behind the harbour, to lay their heads against the pillars and towers, stare at the roof of the neath, dream, open-eyed. Sometimes they speak of things far away, the Carnate's work, the smuggler wars, the Fathom King's secrets. Perhaps it's not all invented. Yes. Do we have shops here? Ah, we do, yeah. Okay, so what I want to do right now is I want to gather Syntellac. It's almost certain to fail, but fuck it. The best of the coral... Okay, first of all, did we succeed? Nope, we failed. The best of the coral will fetch a high price in London, but walk the reefs of the principles, and you risk delusion and despair. Take your crew, and go carefully. Polypoid whispers, fuck me, that's a lot. It's against local law and custom to break coral from the reef, and you've seen the scars of those who tried. The acid burns, the blind silver eyes... So you're looking for loose fragments. Today the Z is calm, and you find a good few candidates. They lie shining softly like droplets of moon. But after a little while, you become concerned at their eyes, that each is watching you. When you close your fist around and it examines your blood with amused delight, when you put them together in your pocket, they clatter and gossip together. Of course, you think. They broke from the shining mind. They have its vitality, but not its weariness or experience. You'll have to lock them in separate boxes, lest they peep at you when you're bathing and see who you are. The thought of their sight on your skin fills you with horror. What if your skin turned clear? What if they saw your bones? You come back to yourself and see one of your Zaylas fall on his back and start kicking delightedly in the air like a beetle. Gravity! He cries. I have fallen! You hasten back to the ship with your hull full of coral before it can do any further damage. Really, all we got was one Syntillac. Sounds like we got loads, but we only got one. Strange. Yeah, let's play chess. Chess is popular in the principles. The port is full of exiles, drunks, and washed-up Z-traders. They all play, often obsessively. Be careful. The chess pieces are carved from Syntillac. Here in the principles, that can be very dangerous. Is it succeeded? Good. Odd thoughts bubble up each time you touch a chess piece. This one longs for home. That one has a secret desire for revenge against the slayer of its rankmate. This will be a queen one day. Those would do better as metal. You taste the metal. You ignore these thoughts and move methodically to a victory over your opponent. He blinks. Checkmate? He asks helplessly. Oh, increased our pages. Good. Do it again. Yep, same response. I believe the more you do this, the more difficult it gets. Yeah, your opponent shakes your hand. Time to go, she tells you. But don't worry, he'll be back. Her touch lingers. Her fingers are cold. A loss. Yep. A distraction. We failed, but in a different way. You don't often look at chess pieces. Not really look. The bishops with the hooks. The knight with an N for some reason. With its mane and teeth. That's got to be deliberate. The kin and the cream, white mingled with red. The roots that pin the corner of the board down to keep you safe from your opponent. You lift a paw to toy with it, to touch its velvety pads. Checkmate, your opponent says. She grins. Look too closely, did we? You need to be careful with Syntillac chess sets. Her face is blank and white as the dome of a chess pawn. Get out. Get back to the ship until the waking dream of the coral clears. Let's give it one more try and then we'll head out. A distraction. Yeah, okay, one more. Discipline success. Good, okay. It's all I wanted. One more victory. That's it. Okay, so let's get the fuck out of here. Let's get out of here before we go mad. Frankly, from the way our character speaks, at least I assume that we... I don't know whether or not we're supposed to accept that the dialogue that we see in the game. I don't know if we're supposed to read that as being our character's internal monologue. Or whether or not that's just like... Or whether or not that's like an omniscient narration. You know, it's probably an omniscient narration, but given the amount of shit that our character sees and will do over the course of a game of Sunless Sea, it's safe to exclaim that all's... It's safe to exclaim. Exclaim. It's a new word. I invented it. Patent fucking pending. No, it's safe to assume. What fucking words did I accidentally slam together to create exam, I ask you? Okay, I don't know. Did I hit that? I must have hit that, because there was nothing here to set me off. Oh, it's you. Far off. Very far off. Someone screams. Get away! Get away from me! Leave, you vile swine. Okay. Well, let's deal with this restless night, shall we? In the watches of the night, you pad softly past the hatch to the crew quarters. A man cries out softly in his sleep, desperately. Another. Inquire about the dreams the next morning. Failed. Shit. The whole neath lit up like a snuffer mask. There's something in the roof, Captain. It is the roof. It's watching us. Eyes and a face. Eyes and a face! You have him subdued. No discipline this time. You require your first officer to keep an eye on him. Ah, yes. My first officer. My non-existent first officer. Well, let's, yes, yes, let's accept a volunteer. Because we can afford one. Let's just compile the port report. Right, off we trot. Anywhere else? Is anything else between us and... Nah, I think right now it's a straight shot back to London. No, actually... Oh, hello. Hello, you daft cunt. You picked a fight with a much better ship than you. You know that. You probably shouldn't have done that, should you? Stout crate. Ah, just some supplies. Right, how much hold space do we have? 32. Right, what I actually want to do is there's something around here, I believe, that I want to go and find, just because we can make actually a good bit of scratch if we do manage to find it. And the search will whittle down our resources enough so that we can actually carry... Oh, Shepherd Isles. It's not what I was looking for. Maybe the Regal Complex... It might be connected to the Regal Complexes. The Shepherd Isles. Never do manage to care about what happens in you. I can't remember anything that happens to this place, I should say. Remember, there's another port, just a couple of feet to the left. Of course, the bearded watchman tells you, there are no actual shepherds on Shepherd Island. Sheep are mostly illegal here. No, indeed, it's just the name of the gentleman that found the islands. Greybeard, sitting in the village square, nods solemnly. No sheep, says. Plenty of tails. Ask us anything. Well, port. Oh yes, there's some goings on. The bleak light of the false stars, surface roiling like a porridge pot, up with a roar of steam and a flash of fire, three windows swimming, tentacles! Then we saw His Highness. There's rather a lot of this material. Yes, gibberish stories. Tales of the Three Graves, go on then. Up from the Z-bed. You know the drownies, the Zailers, what won't rest? Well, they rest here. I've seen them come up out of the water all white and dripping and dig themselves into the ground. They take turns. I think they miss the feel of the earth. Oh, do we have a navigator? Where are you? Oh, you're a first officer, the sigil, the navigator. Let me guide your ship. I know all the Z, how it was, how it will be. Please, the headaches only stop when I'm working. 50 echoes? Yeah, sure. Weirdly, this is actually, I think this guy is the only, officer that you hire whose storyline I've completed. I'm not going to tell you what happens, because it's relatively interesting, but yeah, he's the only one who's actually completed. What do you upgrade mine of? Mirrors. What do you upgrade? Hearts. And you upgrade my veils, don't you? Yes, it's increased my veils. It's increased my veils 6 times, actually. Yep. Right, I believe there is an abbey that has its own port, just a couple of feet in this direction. Oh, hello, another... Oh, good, mob. More silly-ass pirates. Ah, well, we are in a fog bank, which means neither of us can see the other one with any level of certainty. Hi there! Yeah, I was gonna say, if I miss from this range, missed from this range, pretty pissed off. Okay, missed twice from this range, excruciatingly pissed off. Thrice from this range. You know what, let's leave it to fully... Yeah, didn't miss that time, did I, arsehole? And what's in the cache? Oh, a firkin of prisoners, honey. I don't know if that's valuable or not. And I also don't know if that's legal or not. Right, I don't think we're finding this stuff that this place I wanted to find in this journey. We'll go out looking for it another time, I feel. And also, I can't be bothered trying to find that other place. The port, the kind of abbey port, which perhaps isn't actually right next to it, that island, generally. Perhaps that was just a weird accident the last time I played it. Or maybe it was mere, like... Oh, it is right next to it, but in a different direction. Okay, it's down here, right. Okay, let's go check this out and then make a beeline back for London. Yeah, we're not looking too good on fuel. Hopefully we should be able to just about make it. And if necessary, the Abbey Rock does actually sell you things. I believe they will sell us fuel, just at an extortionate rate. Hi there. Here the grim sister's lair, a black spit of an island, far from anywhere anyone would want to go. And that's how the sisterhood likes it. Here stands their fortress convent. There are bear traps that look friendlier than this. Compile a port report. Nothing is happening. The sisters watch us. We feel their eyes. The sea crashes on the rocks, withdraws. The fortress stands stolid as the last year of a century. The greatest peril you risk here is a certain purpleness of prose. Sorry. Just this game. This game complaining about purple prose. It's pretty impressive. Okay, they don't sell fuel. That's a bit of a bitch. Okay, watch the convent since we have the something awaits you in port. Dangerous training. Like huge and deadly herons, the sisters stalk along the very tops of the walls. You watch through a spyglass as they leap and whirl, slashing at each other with a variety of frightening weapons. God, one of them just turned a somersault. Yes. Again, the sisterhood is another thing that you can use recent news on. But right now we don't have any recent news, so... not doing it. Might be worth checking on Pigmoat Island since we're nearby. We might at the very least be able to get a bit more fuel there. Although we probably won't be able to do anything other than that, assuming they let us onto the island, for the simple reason that I think I just wasted the thing that would have let me get in a new event on the island. But I think at the very least we can get another port report, get some more money for it. I don't know if it's immediately, it's like after you, like one, I don't know if it's every repeat report, but past a certain point you stop getting favor from the Admiralty for repeat port reports. I don't know exactly when that happens. Like, I don't know at which point it cuts off. Do you know what I mean? I'm hoping it's not immediate. Hey there, Pigmoat Island, how are you? File a port report. Captain Whiskers, the Admiralty calls you, so you've heard. At least they pay to laugh at your reports. You're in your bit of a cabbie ghetto. Smuggle food in. Yeah, go on there. Visit the cavey ghetto. Smuggle yet more food in. Oh. Oh, we got more prisoners, honey, for helping the, cabbies. Then we can actually afford to give away two more, of these. Regular gate guards not dare search the hairless advisor. If you care for lies, get you and your supplies through without incident. Starving cabbies have little to repay your kindness, but for what they manage to keep from their ship. Yeah. Oh, thank you so much for giving us, some supplies. Here. Have some supplies. We have a 60% chance of brokering a union, so let's give it a go. Marinia will be stronger if its two houses work together. Failed. Damn. Cavighetto, give them that food again. Open that. Fuel. Okay, that's good. We did actually need fuel. That's a benefit. And let's try this again. Okay, cool. We succeeded. Right. Hail Marinia! Chief Engineer Edgar is a pragmatic rat. He listens to your proposition and agrees to discuss the future. The Seneschal, no less proud for the mud in her fur, holds firm on her people's needs, but is ready to compromise on a few of their wants. In particular, we renounce all our claims to... She almost chokes on the words. The Rat Star. The chief engineer sits back. His whiskers twitch happily. The Rat Star, you say? In that case, let us talk terms. Great ships have been dispatched to Pigmoat Island. Yes, well. Good. Okay, cool. I believe that that is essentially what we had to do in order to advance the plot on Pigmoat Island. Is it even worth stopping at Mutton Island on the way? Is it even worth? I'm gonna do it, but I guarantee you the 5 fucking coins we're gonna get for doing it is not worth it. I mean, we might as well. I mean, we're passing by, so... It makes sense. Plus, that actually puts us right next to the wall of the Z, which means we are almost completely unlikely. It's almost impossible, I believe, to actually run into anything threatening that close to London and that close to the wall of the Z. So, yeah, sure. I guess it's fine. Also, I'm imagining already, ladies and gentlemen, even though I believe I mentioned it before, you're kind of seeing the loop of this game, where you just kind of head out, find some ports, and then try and hit every port that you've already met for on the way. We got our port apart. Let's head over to London. I'm just gonna shut up for a minute so you can just listen to this music, because this game's music is fucking beautiful. Isn't the music in this game great? Okay, let's collect our messages. Alright, souls delivered. What a propitious and encouraging occasion this is to meet again here in this place which has been so very fortunate for us both. Allow me to shake you warmly by the hand since you've demonstrated your unswerving commitment to fair dealing and honest conveyage. Very good. My patron will toast you. Yes, cover my costs, please. 200 echoes, fuel and supplies, lovely. Here is your compensation, a little fuel and a few barrels of biscuits, what a certain other captain has widely surrendered for the common good. I will take the good word to my patron, and if I am a man of my word, we will see each other again. Unless a whale eats you, of course, in which case I hope you will not think poorly of me wishing that we will not. It's a fair point. Wait. Once more, we find ourselves here on the quayside of what I suppose you might say is the lip of the well of opportunities. Let us both drink deep from this well, by which I mean my patron has a task for you. Take a payment across the ocean. Bring back a little package. Of course, if you return to London without the little package, probably have something sharp to say about it. Go on, then. You know, we need to go to Khan's heart. That's... Now bring the package here. Here, it is my hearty recommendation that you avoid the ungentle attentions of the excise. On account of if you return without the package, it is of no interest to my patron whether you have lost it or had it taken from you. Good luck. Good luck. Right. Yes. Don't think we have anything for you. Nope, still nothing. Admiral! Strategic intelligence. Good. Pay me. Good. Yes. Submit my port reports. Hunter's Keep. Standard. Mount Palmerston. The Brimstone Convention. They trouble me, Captain. Yes. A visit to that has been recorded. We got our favours. Got 40 echoes. Got some fuel. Port Cecil. The Principles of Coral. I have no idea why anyone thought that settlement was a good idea. 30 echoes. Favour. Yep. Vendor Bite. Oh, it seems to be immediate that we start losing these. Wither, I refuse to ask any questions. I don't want to give them the satisfaction. Yeah, that's fair. I have never succeeded submitting what I hear from the Shepherdars as fact. Nope. Mm-mm. Candidly, I'm not sure why you saw fit to trouble us with this nonsense. Is there anything else? Yes. Yeah, fuck you. Abbey Rock, categorized it as a military installation, you know. Although that has occasioned some quite vigorous debate. Yes. Pigmoat Island, thank you. Chapel of Lights. There's something about the Untersee that breeds heresy and dissent. I rather think we might need to send the Bishop of Southwark out for a bit of good Christian, shouting. 20 echoes. Yep. Avid Horizon. I hope you intend to tell me that everything is quiet there. Yes, quite pleased. And now I've got a visit from Mr. Sachs. We'll deal with that in the next episode. Exiled for giving answers. That's Wither for you. Anything that... Yeah, there we go. I knew that was no connected. Wait, I think I mentioned that in the last video. So, hopefully you watched the last one. Otherwise, my reaction there won't make any sense. Quick as ever, Majorani, the original rubbery lumps. Yep. And Demio Island. Yep. Right. Well. We're going to have to deal with Mr. Sachs next time we record. Well, that's going to have to be all from me for now. I've been your humble letter, Sardis Thinker. And as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week. And if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the Sideways Thinker. Do not seek the Pardoner.